do it.
Hello, I'm the general manager for the Portland Trailblazers, and I'd like to thank you for meeting with us. We have a pair of picks in the lottery at the 6th and 11th slots, and would like to ask you a few questions. Aside from a few veterans, this is a very young team. We're bringing in a lot of young talent this offseason, and it won't be easy to get this team back into the playoffs immediately. Are you willing to take your lumps as a team in order to grow as a core along with all the other young talent the Blazers have?
Why not? Shoot, I can do anything just about right now. Shoot, I'm only a rookie. It ain't like I'm an all-star.
Yeah, I mean, I'd like to think that I have the mental fortitude to grow together as a team. You don't see teams as young as the Blazers get to the top without some growing pains, so I'm prepared for that. But really, I'm excited to be a part of a new era here and would love to help bring Portland back to the top of the league.
Speaking of new era, can I get a fitted with that or a snapback?
Okay, last question. This question is a tough one to ask, as there really isn't a right or wrong answer. Over the last couple of years, we've had entire seasons washed out by insurmountable injuries. As a franchise, we're becoming more conscious on injury histories and what that means for our draft picks. What can you tell us about your injury history, and more importantly, your ability to play through pain?
Well, this one time in college, I was hitting some shorty and I caught a mad Charlie horse. Does that count? Nah, I don't think that counts. Well, this one time in band camp, nah, we're not going to get into that. Nah, I really didn't have that many injuries in my career. I'm only a rookie, so ain't nothing happened to me in a rookie showcase game.
Fortunately, I've been blessed with good health, man. I think the worst injury I've ever had was a sprained ankle, you know? I picked up some knocks over the years, but it's never held me back in practice or in games. I feel like I'm a safe pick for you guys in that regard.
Yeah, safe pick.
That's great. Those answers were music to our ears. With any luck, you'll fall to us in the draft.
Oh, the Hornets.
Greetings. I'm the GM and Director of Player Personnel for the Hornets. In addition to first pick, we also have the 10th pick in the upcoming draft and are looking at you with one of those picks. We would like to get to know you better by asking you a couple questions. Let's get to it. Being in the NBA brings a lot of responsibilities, and some people just aren't ready for it, if you know what I mean. What are your plans once you get that first paycheck?
Shoo, man, when I get that mugga, what? The first thing I'm doing, I'm hitting up Saks Fifth, right? I gotta get the Louis belt, gotta get the Gucci belt. It's only right. I gotta get the shoes to match. Oh, man, woo, that first check, boy. Now, you know what? Nah, I'm going to keep it simple, man. I'm going to help out moms. It's only right. She got me here. You know what I'm saying?
Easy answer. My parents have spent their entire life putting me into the position I'm in right now. I want nothing more than to take care of them and make sure that the rest of their lives are as carefree as possible. I don't need glitz and glamour. I just need my loved ones cared for.
What a question and answer.
Interesting. Next question. Do you feel pressure to be good right away in this league?
Nah, not at all, man. It's only going to take me about a week to get used to the flow of the NBA. And after that, a star is born. That's all. That's what my mama used to say. It's like, nah, man, I'm not pressured at all, man. I pressure myself all the time. I'm just that good.
Nah, I won't feel any pressure to be good right away. I understand the NBA has the greatest basketball players in the world. I get that. There'll definitely be a learning curve to the level of play here. I'll adjust in time, and when I do adjust, watch out, baby.
Okay.
Great answers. I really think you'd fit in great with us. Here's hoping we're able to draft you with our pick.
Nice performance tonight. I'm GM and President of Team Operations for the Suns. We have the 13th pick in the draft and considering using it on you. I'd like to ask you a couple questions real quick if you don't mind. This offseason, we said goodbye to an era as Steve Nash left our team. With his departure, we're looking to the future for a point guard who can do what he was able to do for us. Do you think you can be that player?
Why not, man? I'm from a city called Dime City. Shoot, I got dimes for days. I could drop assists and all that.
It would be an honor to follow in the footsteps of one of the greatest point guards to ever play. Growing up, I dreamed of being like Steve Nash. And if I could take over the reins of the point guard spot in Phoenix, man, it'd be a dream come true.
You hear that? A dream come true. That's what I'm talking about.
All right, then, one more. As a whole, the Suns have kept the same core for the better part of a decade. We found a winning formula and stuck by it, just rotating in supporting pieces where necessary. As I'm sure you've seen over the last year or so, we're in the midst of overhauling our roster. We really love the idea of you being a part of that process. What do you think about being a centerpiece for the new Phoenix Suns?
Man, y'all trying to put me at the centerpiece position? Why not? Shoot, I like being a star already. You seen I'm about to get drafted, right?
Man, I love the idea that you consider me a centerpiece. That type of confidence in me, how can I not love the idea? I'm interested in making a name for myself in the NBA, and Phoenix sounds like a great fit to me.
Yeah.
Okay, good stuff. We'll be in touch if we have any other questions.